Treatments for bleeding disorders work in different ways in the body, so it is important to understand the science between the different types of treatments. There are some proteins that our body produces as part of our immune system. These proteins are called antibodies, and they are shaped like a Y. The arms of the Y allow antibodies to recognize and bind to proteins on bacteria, viruses, or other substances they don't recognize. A special type of antibody is made in a lab and called a bispecific antibody. A bispecific antibody, bi meaning two, helps by allowing each arm of the Y to attach to two specific proteins to bring them together. A person who has a bleeding disorder may be missing or may not have enough of one of the proteins, called factors, that helps blood clot. Factors are part of the clotting cascade, and they work together so that blood can clot and bleeding can stop. For example, in hemophilia A, the factor VIII protein is missing, or there is not enough of this protein available. Factor VIII is needed to bond to two proteins, activated factor IX and factor X, so that factor X can be activated. This is an important part of the clotting cascade. A bispecific antibody can be used in place of factor VIII. Activated factor IX will attach to one arm of the bispecific antibody, and factor X will attach to the second arm of the bispecific antibody. This will bring the factors close enough together so that they can bond and factor X can be activated so the clotting cascade can continue. This treatment is also called non-factor replacement therapy, or mimetic, when it is used for hemophilia A. In this case, a mimetic is something that mimics the role of factor VIII, so factor VIII is not needed for the clotting cascade to continue. As with any treatment, there are benefits and limitations when using a bispecific antibody to treat hemophilia A. Some benefits are: the treatment is given under the skin by injection. It is an approved treatment option for people with and without inhibitors. The ability to clot is at a more steady level compared to most factor replacement therapies that have peaks and troughs. It is also given less frequently than some other treatments, once a week, once every 2 weeks, or every 4 weeks. Some of the limitations. This treatment is only approved for people who have hemophilia A. It is used to prevent bleeds, not to treat bleeds, so factor infusions or bypassing agents may still be needed for injuries, surgery, or spontaneous breakthrough bleeding. This medication can interfere with some lab tests, so make sure your provider knows you are on a bispecific antibody. Factor VIII levels are unchanged, which means they remain in the below normal range. There can be negative side effects with some medications used to treat bleeding in those with inhibitors. Talk to your healthcare provider about which treatment is best for you. This video is brought to you by the National Bleeding Disorders Foundation.